This is Susan Bradley for CSO Online. Recently, there have been several reports of fake updaters that pretend to be browser landing pages that spoof Chrome, Firefox, and Internet Explorer, and probably even Edge. When the user clicks on the upgrade option, a JavaScript file is downloaded and executes the malware. Here's an example here where Wasted Locker used this SOC Goalish framework. So it delivered a victim a zipped file via compromised legitimate websites. It contained malicious JavaScript masquerading as a browser update. So what can you do to prevent these kinds of ransomware attacks? Well, obviously there's plenty. First off, I hope no one actually receives .js or .jse files at the email gateway level. There's no logical reason for any user in your environment to be receiving or emailing JavaScript files to a normal average user or workstation. You should also, while you're at it, review the file types that you block on a regular basis and ensure that only those file types you want are allowed. So look at your firewalls, your email, file transfer types, any other means that files come into and out of your office. Make sure you review everything on a regular basis to make sure it's what your policies should be. Next, do something I call the poor man's protection. You can go into default apps by file type and reassign .js and .jse to different file types. For example, rather than the default of the Windows-based script host, you can change it and actually go to something like Notepad. If you have access to Intune, you can go into Devices, Configuration Profiles, Platform of Windows 10 or later, choose Endpoint Protection. You want to create the policy. I'm going to call it, I'll just call it Test for now. And you want to come down here to Microsoft Defender Exploit Guard. And you want to go to Attack Surface Reduction. And you can see down here, you can rules to prevent script threats. You can configure that. Now, initially, you may want to click on audit only. In your environment, you may want to test it and then later on come back and change it to block. And while you're here in Intune, if you have access to this, you can look at all of your other options you have. Attack surface reduction rules are very powerful, and especially in Intune, they're very much easier to review. If you're familiar with the group policy settings for attack surface reduction, you'll remember that you have to use GUID codes in order to enable them. So it can be a little bit daunting. This is a lot easier to understand what you're enabling and disabling in an environment. Last but certainly not least, you can use PowerShell. As you can see, you can do the set MP preference, turn on the attack surface reduction rules. This is the GUID code specifically for the blocking of the JS, and you want to enable it. Get the idea that there's lots of ways that you can block scripting inside your environment. Take the time to fully understand all of the different controls and abilities you have in your environment. Many times you don't have to buy new licenses. You already have the power inside your own system. Until next time, this is Susan Bradley for CSO Online.